Hi, this is Miles Lewis with Lewis Manor Labradoodles, and pretty soon you're going to be picking up a puppy. And so we wanted to put a little video together to go over some of the information in the folders, go over some basic instructions when you first pick up your puppy here, or possibly have a puppy delivered to you, so that you can have this video to reference, get all the information, and perhaps play it back so you can use this so you can remember feeding instructions, housebreaking tips, and other advice that we give once you have a new Lewis Manor Labradoodle. So the first thing you're gonna get when you have your puppy either delivered or you pick up is you're gonna go through this folder here. It might be a different color. I just have one of the puppies folders from one of our current litters here. It's going home tomorrow. And you'll notice in the front, you have the microchip ID and what litter they're from. And this happens to be Green Boy, the green collared boy in the litter. And so what you wanna do is open it up and we'll go over this with you when you come or when we deliver, but it's all the same. All the folders are put together the exact same way. So on the left-hand side, we have their microchip ID information, and this is a tag you can always hook onto their collar, and the microchip ID number is on here as well, and you don't have to do anything with this. Christina will finish the registration for you, so it's really ready to go. Also, in this whole left-hand side here, which I'm just gonna set pieces down here as I go, can look a little bit different depending on which lab we use. But on the left side, we have a parasite report. We do a fecal check on all of our dogs and puppies before they go home. This one happened to have no parasites seen. It was a clean fecal. However, it's important that we let you know that it, just because the fecal exam is clear, does not mean that your puppy doesn't have parasites. A lot of times the stress of going to a new home can sort of release the parasites, and then they'll show up in a fecal exam. It's not uncommon for a puppy to show parasites even a few days or a week after they go home. So you're gonna wanna do your own fecal exam with your vet at your first vet visit. It'll be important to look for anything in there and then go by your vet's recommendations for any kind of treatment or dewormer that there might be. It's also possible that oftentimes puppies are sent home and we did see something positive on their fecal exam, and we try to always treat whatever parasite is recommended or needed before they go home, whether it's something common like Giardia or Coccidia or perhaps some worms or something like that. All very common parasites that we see in puppies, but we do our best to treat them beforehand, but it doesn't mean that they won't need another treatment. Just, you know, to prepare you basically that parasites are just part of dog ownership, and it's usually very simple to treat them, especially if you catch it as early as possible, and just go by whatever your vet recommends as far as the treatment goes for that. So you'll have one of those in your folder. You want to give all this stuff to your vet, all these vet records that we have here. And then the next page will be our own vet's exam of each individual puppy. So next page will just be a quick health or wellness check for the puppy. They might make some notes on there. You might see something like a umbilical hernia or a cosmetic hernia, or perhaps a misaligned tooth. They would call it medially set canine. Those are pretty common, or anything that the vet notices, she's gonna write on this exam note here. So it doesn't mean that it's not a healthy dog, but they really wanna pretty much notice anything that they see that's perhaps out of the ordinary, just something to keep an eye on. And we try to do our best to let you know that before your puppy gets picked up or delivered, but this will be the record for that. It'll also have their birthday and all the information on there. So you can just give this right to your vet as well when you take your puppy to their first vet exam. That's draft one. The next one here in the line is gonna be the internal vet records, or sorry, the medical records that we use here. So you're gonna have, when we do our deworming schedule, our vaccines, all those things, this little sticker here is gonna be basically the vaccine record from doing that. And so you'll want to also just give this right to your vet so they can add it to their records. And the next pages throughout the folder here is just some informational stuff about, you know, something you can hang on your fridge, how to interact with dogs. And then we also have some, just again, some informational things about how to interact with dogs, how dogs or kids shouldn't interact with dogs, you know, just how to be safe around dogs, basically. And there's a few other just care and maintenance type things for your puppy. A little bit of information about diatomaceous earth. There's a white powder that we sent home in your red go-home bag, and this explains why we use it, sort of like a preventative maintenance dewormer and how much to use as well. So there's information on the diatomaceous earth there. And then there's a grooming guide about brushing, nail clipping, ear cleaning. Labradoodles tend to be prone to, kind of yeasty or ear infections. And so you want to make sure that you use a good ear cleaner and ear wash to kind of maintain their ears and keep them free from infections. So there's information about that, how often to bathe them, all those kinds of things in this printout right here. And there's also a grooming guide, which you can always give right to your groomer. If they ask you how would you like your doodle to be cut, you can basically say, well, this is how we like it to be cut right here. So kind of gives them some information on what they should do and shouldn't do as far as grooming goes. On the other side of the folder here, on the right-hand side, is going to be two copies of the health warranty and contract. There'll be a place on the back for you to sign. If you could sign both copies, one copy is for you, one copy is for us to keep, and all that's in there. Same, or should be the same, contract that's also on our website as well. Now there's gonna be some more informational things on this right-hand side about Trupanion pet health insurance. There's gonna be quite a few printouts about that. If you sign up your puppy within the first 24 hours of getting your puppy, you get a free 30 days coverage from Trupanion. I highly recommend that. They don't take your credit card information down. They are obviously would like to continue to do business with you, but they're not gonna automatically bill you or anything like that. So highly recommend Trupanion pet health insurance. There's also gonna be some information about NuVet vitamins. There's a code on the back that you can order more. There's also a little sample pack in your red bag as well with a few. It's just a daily multivitamin, once a day kind of a thing. When they're small, you can even break it in half, give it to them like a treat when they go in their kennel. They are tasty, so they will eat them happily. And a few more printouts about NuVet vitamins. There's just some more informational stuff about vaccines, about not over-vaccinating, not under-vaccinating. That would be helpful for you as well. And then there is also a printout from Baxter and Bella, which is a puppy training curriculum. It's sort of a do-it-yourself online puppy training class. If you didn't go through our training program, and or even if you did, it really has great information still in here. But with a coupon code Lewis Manor, you get 25% off. Highly recommend you check out BaxterandBella.com. Lewis Manor is the coupon code. It's really great. We like it because they do training a lot like we do training, a lot of positive reinforcement, and it covers everything from socializing and housebreaking. All those things are included, as well as basic obedience in the Baxter and Bella program. And that's pretty much it. There's just some more printouts from NuVet. Should be just about everything in there as well. And then we have the folder is pretty much all set. So you sign that, give us a copy. You'll keep a copy for your records. You always want to hang on to that folder because it's going to have all the important documents in it. The next most popular question we get asked is feeding. What should we do for feeding your puppy when you get home? So we feed Life's Abundance, and likely you're going to be, your puppy will be on the Life's Abundance medium-sized puppy formula. We usually continue that until they're about 6 months old or so, and then we switch into the all-life stages. So, you know, after a couple months, 2 or 3 months, you'll be able to start transitioning them to the all-life stages variety. Life's Abundance food can be ordered right from our website. If you check out the Getting Ready Center portion of our website, there is a link to order the correct food right on our website there. So how much to feed them is the question we usually get asked. And we feed our dogs, our older dogs, we let them free feed, 99% of them. It's as much or as little as they want to eat. So when they're puppies, we like to have 3 meal times a day, morning, midday, and an evening, like breakfast, lunch, and dinner kind of a thing. And we just give them as much food as they want to eat in that short amount of time. Maybe it's 5 minutes until they lose interest. So if they only take 2 nibbles and they lose total interest and they're not trying to eat more, that's totally normal. They often graze. They don't usually eat an entire bowl of food. Maybe the next meal, they might eat the entire bowl of food. It's totally okay to give them more food and fill up their bowl a little bit until they are completely satisfied. They'll regulate themselves very, very well. Again, 99% of our dogs regulate themselves very well with the food. So it's as much or as little food as you want to give them. You don't need to add water to the food or anything like that. Just the dry kibble is really all they need, and give them plenty of opportunities to drink water throughout the day, especially after exercise. But we do the meal times 3 times a day, mainly to help with housebreaking. So the feeding schedule, most dogs, we have a little mantra. And if you write this down, it'll really help you with the housebreaking process. All you gotta remember is the letters ESP, which stands for after they eat, after they sleep, and after they play. You should take them outside to go potty. So, first thing in the morning, they wake up. It's not playtime, it's not food time, it's immediately. They woke up, time to go outside and go potty. So, every time you put them away in the kennel, or every time they're taking a nap on the rug, if they wake up even after a short nap, 20 minutes or 2 hours or overnight, the first thing you should do when your puppy is young is take them outside to go potty. Chances are they woke up because they have to go potty. So after they eat, every time they eat or drink, you're going to want to take them out immediately after. When I say immediately, I mean within 30 seconds to a minute if you can. When they're this young, 8 weeks old, 9 weeks old, you're going to see a lot more success, because dogs, just the way their body works, is they eat, they drink, and they have to eliminate it. It's just the way their body works. So if they nibble for a couple minutes on something, you know, pretty much take them out right after. Same with a big drink of water after running around. Even if you just took them outside, they've gone poop, they've gone pee, they've pottied, they come back inside, they take a big drink of water, I would take them right back outside right after that. It's not uncommon for a dog to have to go potty a minute after it has just drinking a lot, or have to poop after it's eaten quite a bit. Even not a lot of it, it might still have to go. And it never is, there's no such thing as taking your dog outside too much. That'll really help set the tone for, you know, having success outside, and the housebreaking process can be that much easier. So one of the best tools we have for the housebreaking process is the use of the kennel or the crate. And it's important that you don't give a dog too much freedom too fast. So that's true with the size of room they're in. It's also true with the size of kennel that they're in. They should really be given just enough kennel size to stand up without hitting their head on the ceiling, and they should be able to spin around and lay down and look comfortable. They shouldn't be stuffed in there like a sausage, but if you have a kennel that's too big, you'll also have a problem of them feeling like one half is like, you know, they got the penthouse suite. They feel like this half over here is their bathroom, and then the front half is where they sleep, and they have a living room up there. And they'll just start having accidents in their kennel if it's too big. So an appropriate size kennel, one of our wire crates that we sell, Midwest makes them, or Amazon sells them as well. You want to use that little divider that comes with it. As they get bigger, you can give them more and more freedom. So use the kennel every time you're not able to watch them. And I tell people to watch their puppy like you're watching a toddler in the shallow end of a pool. You can't be on your phone, you can't turn around, you can't be making dinner. At a moment when you look away, they're often gonna squat and have to go potty. So the key is take them out as often as you can after they eat, after they sleep, after they play. If they're playing in the living room and they're having fun, you're playing tug of war, whatever you're doing, and all of a sudden they stop and they are wandering to some other area of the house, that is your cue. That dog has to go potty. So as soon as they stop playing, take them right outside to go potty. We also recommend the first day that you take a puppy into your home, you keep them either in the kennel or outside to go potty. If you go back and forth between the kennel and outside, they're gonna learn much quicker that the place is not okay to go inside the house, because they won't be given the opportunity to have an accident in the house. And then the next day you can keep them on a leash even, tether them and let them wander maybe a couple rooms in the house. Slowly give them more and more freedom, but a little bit controlled with the leash, so that if they squat and have to go potty, you see them, you know where they are at all times, you can take them out quickly. And you can do this really for even weeks. You can do this throughout your house, and it really is going to help you have a lot more success if you don't ever leave your puppy unsupervised with too much freedom for not having accidents in the house. So again, ESP, after they eat, after they sleep, after they play, take them outside and use an appropriately sized kennel. Always keep them kenneled whenever you can't supervise them closely. The next question we get is, how much should I socialize this puppy? And it's, you know, it's a risk, because the puppies are not fully vaccinated until they're about 16 weeks old when they get their third shot. Especially parvo is a very contagious and very deadly, you know, virus that dogs can pick up. And, you know, there is definitely a risk. They are covered somewhat because they are vaccinated, but basically their own antibodies are fighting this vaccine. That's why we have to give them the three boosters. But our opinion is that it's better to err on the side of socializing and just be cautious rather than to never take them outside. Some vets will recommend that you never take your dog outside until they're fully vaccinated. The problem with that is that you're gonna very likely end up with a dog that is going to be very fearful, very timid, very shy, and not able to take in the world around them properly. Here, we try to have our dogs and puppies meet at least 50 people before they go home at 8 weeks old. And for our training program, we try to have them meet hundreds and hundreds of people before they go home at 3, 4, or 5 months old or so. So it's important to continue that socializing, good, positive experiences, friendly dogs that are vaccinated, they should be around. They should meet all different kinds of people, different sizes, different ages, people in different settings. It's all gonna help them if they experience these things before they turn 16 weeks old when they're fully vaccinated. And the more of that you can do, absolutely the better it's gonna be for that dog. So it has a well-rounded a dog as an adult and has as few fear tendencies as possible. So that's pretty much it on socializing. I would avoid dog parks though. There's a lot of dog traffic at places like that. I would avoid highly trafficked dog areas. But you know, out and about, taking them for walks, meeting neighbors, meeting friends, family, definitely do that as much as you possibly can. I would highly recommend puppy kindergarten type classes. It's a nice controlled environment. Those are gonna be very good as well. That pretty much wraps up most of the questions we get. If you do have other questions for us, the best way to get a hold of us is to shoot us an email. You can use the contact form on our website or just email whoever you've been talking with the most recently. You can also send us messages on Facebook or Instagram, although we prefer email if possible. If you call our office number, it often takes quite a bit of time for us to check those messages and get back to people. But email is the best, and also we would encourage everybody to look us up now that you have one of our puppies. Search on Facebook for the Lewis Manor Labradoodles Owners Group, and you send a request to join and need your puppy's birth date and which litter they came from, and we would love to see you on that private group that we have on Facebook where you can share pictures, ask other questions to other owners, and even find other puppies and dogs that are in your neighborhood or in your area that probably would love to get together and have a puppy play date with you. And that pretty much concludes most of the basic instructions for taking home a new puppy. And hopefully it's a success for you. And if you have any questions, just please don't hesitate to reach out. And congratulations on adopting a Lewis Manor Labradoodle.